good evening, everybody. Cheers. Tonight, I'm going to show you a bit of theory, a bit of history, and several different technical solutions for the same problem. And for me, that's really the nice part of watchmaking. So I am very excited to show you this, to be able to show you this, and I hope you like it as well. The most basic of basics, basic movements, 6497 and 98 from ETA, and most people call it the Unitas because they started producing this this movement. Originally designed as a pocket watch movement. It is quite big. And this is Savonette, so the second hand is on 90 degrees of the winding stem. First, you see if I wind this movement, winding stem, of course, mechanical movement. If I wind just a movement, it starts running. And you hear a click. Well, there's the click. And let's make sure that this wheel don't revolve back. You see? It can only move in one way. Now I'm winding the mainspring, and the mainspring is in the barrel underneath here. And actually what I'm doing is exactly the same as this. I'm winding the toy. There is a mainspring in here. I'm holding the back wheels with my finger. If I release my finger here, all the power from the mainspring is gone. Same here. I'm winding the mainspring, is putting some force in the mechanical toy. We want to store the power of the mainspring in the watch. So if it's gone again, it's no use. We want to store it. Now this one. Exactly the same. I'm winding the toy. Exact same mainspring as the watch, as the model car. And then that happens. But there is a difference, and sorry if this sounds a bit childish, but for me it's the best way to explain what's going on, because this is different than the model car because it isn't too far-fetched. If I attach a pendulum on this, we have a clock. Okay, no hands, but there is a mechanism inside this toy that makes sure that the power is released constantly. Same in a watch. In this toy, TikTok, every single time one well, I'll show you the inside of watch that makes TikTok, and then I won't spill the beans.
Here.
There is the bit that says TikTok in a watch. Maybe if I show it like this. Those are the strange club teeth. There's the balance wheel. I'm going to show you a bit more. If you can see the shape of them teeth over there, you will recognize this. I think you recognize this shape from the watch just now. And you see, this is happening in the watch, that we're looking at the same thing. There is the pivot of this wheel. You see the club teeth here, pedal fork, and the balance wheel. If you think the balance wheel is on top of this and goes back and forth, this is exactly what happened inside the movement, right? I think you've seen that. And you see, every single time when you hear TikTok, one teeth is escaping. There, I marked one teeth. There. There. Over there. So the bit that says TikTok is the escapement, because every single time one teeth is escaping. Well, like I say just about every single stream, hardly anything changed in the last 200 years in watchmaking. So here the balance wheel is going back and forth, just like a pendulum in a clock. And here we have the escapement, because every single time one teeth is escaping. It's échappement, échappement in Dutch, escapement in English, but in German it is called Hemmung. In German it's Hemmung, and that means breaking, because you can see it is one teeth is escaping, but you can say it is breaking the release of the power. So yeah, quite accurate. So now you can see the parallel between and this. It's just about the same. Mainspring, power. So far so good. I think it's if you want to have some more information, please let me know. Breaking the release of the power. Yes, that's it. That's exactly it. So now the balance wheel is going back and forth. You can see there's not too much amplitude. The amount of degrees that the balance wheel is turning. So if you wind it, the power is stored here. And with the balance wheel and the escapement, and this is called a Swiss lever escapement, the power is released, but constantly, bit by bit by bit, and the balance wheel makes sure that the space in between the release of one teeth is quite constant. What you see here is the balance wheel and the balance spring. Out of the Dutch invention, so this is Christian Huygens. And this text is an exact copy from the text he made in 1658. And this was groundbreaking. He was the guy who made the first physics law he wrote down. And due to that physics law, watches will still run on time, and we understand why they run on time. Unfortunately, I do not own yet the original copy of the text, but when I grow up, I'll find one. It's not too much text, but what's in it is critical. Christian Huygens, why the first physics law? That is, and in short, the amplitude is irrelevant for a pendulum swing. Trust me. Here we have a pendulum of a clock. Tick, tock, tick, tock. I hope it's visible. And the amplitude is a swing in degrees. So from there to there is 90 degrees. From there to there is 180 degrees. Yeah? And again, if there are any questions, please let me know. Huygens, the Dutch guy. He figured out that, here we go, tick, 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 tick is exactly the same as tick, 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 tick. Do you see the difference in amplitude? Tick, 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 tick is exactly the same as tick, 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 tick. And even further, tick, tick, tick. The only thing that can differ, make a difference in the time a pendulum swings, is the length of the pendulum. Make it short, it goes fast. Tick, 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 tick. Make it long and it goes slow. Tick, tick, tick. So far so good? Yeah. Probably. So the length of the pendulum is the only thing that can adjust the time it takes to go back and forth. The pendulum swinging like this is exactly the same as the balance spring like this. You can see there, that's the balance spring. And that's exactly the same, salute, thank you, as the pendulum. So make the pendulum short, it will run fast. Make a pendulum go long, it will run slow. And that's exactly what happens here. You can see here the balance spring, which acts exactly the same as the pendulum, remember? So these timing pins here, if you move them over there, the pendulum becomes shorter, so the watch will run faster. If you move these timing pins a bit over here, you make the pendulum longer and the watch run slower. And this is the only thing that can make a watch run faster and slower. Okay, maybe some weights in the balance wheel, but that's it. So only some weights in the balance wheel or the length of the pendulum balance spring can change the rate of a watch, because the rest are teeth, and you cannot remove, well, some teeth, well, you can, but the watch won't run. So that's the only variable in a watch. So if a watch runs fast suddenly, there's only one thing that can happen, because with the pendulum ticking, tick, tock, tick, tock, if two windings like these stick together with magnetism, with some sticky oil or grease, then this happens. I'm not sure if it's visible. So this is the pendulum. And if two windings, you see, the pendulum is exactly the same as the balance spring, like that. So if two windings of the balance spring stick together, this happens, and the pendulum is so much shorter and it will run fast. That's the only thing that can happen that can change the rate in a watch. Simple as that. So only some weights in the balance wheel or the length of the pendulum balance spring can change the rate of a watch, because the rest are teeth, and you cannot remove, well, some teeth, well, you can, but the watch won't run. So that's the only variable in a watch. So now we have the escapement. And you see the balance wheel on top of here, that decides the rate that one teeth is escaping. One step. The rate of this watch. The rate of this one is 18,000 beats per hour. Well, and this is the most basic of rates, is always 5 beats per second. And that hasn't changed for the last 200 years. So we have 1 second is 5 beats. So far, so good. That means 300 beats per minute. So far, so good. 5 times a second, 300 times a minute, 18,000 beats per hour. That's right. If you wind this particular movement, the Unitas 6497, if you wind it once, it has a power reserve of, I believe, 52 hours. 18,000 beats per hour. Every single hour, if you're not looking at your watch, if it's in a chest of drawers, no matter what, 18,000 times per hour, it says tick-tock. Times 52 hours, one power reserve. So one time full winding of this movement is almost a million times this. That's just mind-boggling.